In this video, we are going to be talking about Central New York and its geography, because I'm telling you, it gets pretty weird. So NY-28 is a weird route. It is almost 300 miles long, as in the sense that it begins in Kingston and it ends in Warrensville. So it goes from Ulster to Warren County, but that doesn't seem like it should be so long. What makes it even longer is the fact that it's a C shape, and the fact that it goes through Cooperstown. It begins at just past exit 19 off the thruway at NY-32, and it ends at US 9, almost approaching the Adirondack Northway and almost going into Lake George. The first part of the route is I-587, but at I-587 ends and it continues the rest of its route in a C shape. But anyway, talking about the weird stuff. So, besides Chintandy, there's also Shawari County. So if you want to get from Chintandy to Otsego County, where Cooperstown is, you either have to go through Shawari County or through Montgomery County. While most counties in the southern tier just kind of end at a certain latitude, that's not necessarily true with Delaware County, which actually sticks up north, meaning that it's possible to get from Pennsylvania to Ontario while only going through four counties in New York. The Susquehanna in New York goes through Tioga County and Chemung County, actually going through Binghamton, briefly crosses back into Pennsylvania, but then in Delaware County, it comes back and it ends in Cooperstown at Otsego County. And if you're wondering, Binghamton in Chemung County is approximately 90 minutes from Cooperstown. NY-80, yeah, I'm not really gonna talk too much about NY-80 because it's not like it's a bit more confusing, but yeah, 28 does go through Cooperstown in Otsego County. I believe NY-80 begins in Syracuse, and given that the route's only around 130 miles long, that actually means that Cooperstown has to be within 2 hours at least, and probably even closer to Syracuse, if I am correct on the matter. So that's like how the geography gets weird. Cooperstown is not 90 minutes west of Albany. It's around 60 minutes west of Albany and 30 minutes south of Albany. And I-88 is also a really weird interstate highway. And when you go from like Binghamton to Cooperstown, you will briefly be on 88. exactly what exit I get off if I were to go to Cooperstown. Though Apple Maps is telling me to take the Taconic all the way up to NY-82 to NY-23 to NY-142. It's a really weird route. I believe I'll be on 80 at some point. If I were to take the thruway, though, I would get off at exit 19, which is NY-28. But I haven't been to Cooperstown necessarily that way. I've been there from Lake George, which is around an hour north of Albany, and it was a 2.5 hour drive. If you didn't know, that's in Warren County. So Warren County goes from, so like Warren County is also two from Albany, but in a different direction. So Albany and Albany County, I believe, intersect, although I'm not sure if. Yeah, they do, but neither of them intersect, I don't believe any of them intersect, Otsego. When I went there, yeah, I did go through Montgomery County. But the way we went there is obviously we took I-87 south to exit 1 west to the I-93 west. I believe what we were supposed to do was either take whatever exit was, US 20, I'm not sure. Maybe exit 2 west or 2? What Alvash was recommending was we take exit 13, which I'm not sure what that is, to be perfectly honest, or something like that. Maybe NY-7. NY-7 actually goes through Albany, and the 3-hour connector from Pennsylvania to Vermont. Yeah, it goes through Binghamton. It actually does. Yeah, Binghamton is a confusing place. I'm gonna tell you that. So, largely the fact of the matter is that, really the fact of the matter is that, really, the geography should be, like, weird, but then we actually took exit 29 or 29A on NY-5 south towards NY-10, then we took that to NY-80 into Cooperstown. I don't think that was necessarily the best route taking the thruway, especially because considering that it goes like north in that part. And then I went from Cooperstown to our hotel in Almonk. Actually, no, I didn't. I went to House Cave, I believe. There I was only on NY80, I'm not sure. I did go from House Cave. Then we went to the hotel in Almonk. Did I see the Susquehanna when I went to Cooperstown? No, unfortunately, we saw the, Otsego Lake, but no, not Susquehanna itself. We also didn't cross it, I believe. I have crossed it. I-81 does cross it by Harrisburg, and I was on that part of I-81. Although not when I went to Hershey. I took I-81 to I-83. That's, I believe, just before I crossed the Susquehanna. See, I don't know what drives I take. I don't really know, so I just film whatever content that's available to me. School is close to the rest of the year. They're considering that. Right now it's May 15th, but while they are considering that, that would mean that most non-essential businesses wouldn't open until July 1st. I don't know why they'd be considering that. It's getting better. But Cuomo did say that, I believe he extended the closure. He actually, funnily enough, extended the closure as, New York was dipping. But he'd say it because New Jersey and nearby states were rising, and they had to coordinate on the issue. Funnily enough, though, that was the day that New Jersey began to see a dip in their numbers. So now it's actually getting better in New Jersey. Cuomo is considering, rather than a 2-week extension this time, maybe a 1-week extension so that it could get better in other, it could cool down in other states before anything happens here. Cuomo said that Cuomo also allowed non-essential surgeries in NASDAQ to reopen, although NASDAQ doesn't work in their offices, to begin to reopen the New York economy. He did this in an effort to, so that this way it wouldn't be as bad keeping the city closed until July, which Cuomo was considering. Yeah, North Carolina is closed until May 15th as well. Florida and Texas are actually reopening in 6 days, but we're opening in 20 at the bare minimum. Cuomo said he's not rescinding the order. He said even though it's getting better here, Massachusetts has a pandemic on their hands, and Massachusetts was actually invited into it where they together coordinate a situation where they take up on each other's advice and then do things what other states kind of want them to do. So it's not completely independent anymore.